So I think that we basically, the whole idea of empire is just unsuccessful. It's not a good idea.
Okay.
And that's why it doesn't work. And that's why empires can grow to a certain size and then they're going to fall apart anyway. Because the basis of the idea doesn't work. Because people do not like to be ruled by other people, not like them. You know, a nation doesn't want to be, even if it's not a nation. Peoples don't like to be ruled by other peoples. Doesn't matter how good they are. And the best proof of that is, what did the Romans ever do for us?
Right.
And what have they ever given us in return? The aqueduct? What? The aqueduct?
Oh, yeah, they did give us that. That's true, yeah.
And the sanitation.
Oh, yeah, the sanitation, Reg. Remember what the city used to be like?
Yeah, all right, I'll grant you, the aqueduct and sanitation are two things the Romans have done.
And the roads.
Well, yeah, obviously the roads. I mean, the roads go without saying, don't they? But apart from the sanitation, the aqueduct and the road...
Irrigation. Medicine. Yeah. Education.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, all right, fair enough.
And the wine.
Yeah, that's something we've really missed, Reg, if the Romans left.
Public baths.
And it's safe to walk in the streets at night now, Reg.
Yeah, they certainly know how to keep order. Let's face it, the only ones who could in a place like this.
All right, but apart from the sanitation, the medicine, education, wine, public order, irrigation, roads, the fresh water system and public health, what have the Romans ever done for us?
Brought peace?
Oh, peace! Shut up!
It's proof of it, you know. And so, and that's what's so brilliant about Monty Python. So I think that essentially empires will crumble, not because something is wrong with them, other than they should never have been an empire to start with. Because it's all about conquest and being on top of someone else. And that's fine for the people on top. It's never going to be fine for the people at the bottom. So if you're going to, like, you know, they wrote all these books about...
The Romans weren't that oppressive.
No.
They weren't... Well, no, but I mean, eventually, if you played along, then you would get full citizenship, and you would get...
That was probably only after the year 200.
Okay.
Before that, you couldn't be a Roman citizen.
But it still crumbled after the year 200.
It crumbled long before then. Its decline begins early. It's just we know when it finally falls apart. So I think that the question in itself is you know, people ask that question because they need to write books. but actually, in itself, the whole idea of empire, and Russia is a modern example, because immediately that it falls apart, what do? They all want to make their own little countries. And then, you see, and this is the way it goes, then those little countries are not strong enough, so they're going to band together. And then they become an empire. And then the people at the bottom don't like it, and so they're going to disband it again. So it's just, from itself, it's not going to work.
Okay, now, you said nations, and then you said, well, not necessarily
nations.
Yeah, because
nation is like a modern idea. We're an ancient nation. We already knew we were a nation long before anybody else understood what nation was.
Oh, the Greeks understood it.
No,
more or less
they weren't, because you had Sparta.
But then...
Yeah, and then they understood
converged.
It for a bit.
Yeah.
They understood it for a bit.
So, it wasn't like... I agree that we are probably the first nation that can even... That
see,
can...
they couldn't be the same as us, because with them, every city had a different god. And so they couldn't really be a nation united by the religion.
Yeah.
So then it's going to be, you know, well, his god's better than his god. So we actually, I'm really not a professor, and I don't know that I'm not talking rubbish here, but we might actually be one of the first nations.
I think we are the first.
So the idea of nationhood is very young, very modern. It's 17th century stuff, you know.
I think nationalism is very young.
Yes. Yeah.
But nationhood, I think it stretches, because if you, like...
We have to define nation.
The definition is pretty pretty straightforward. It means a large group of people with some common language, common heritage, some common ancestry also goes into it. But the difference between a nation and just an ethnic group is that a nation is connected to a specific strip of land. They have known borders. That's the difference between... That's why you can interchange country and nation, more or less, because a nation has to be specifically defined by the land it is
on. Okay, in that case, we can't be a nation because our borders keep changing.
Well, but...
We'll take another
one. No, but we do know that we are in the Levant area, so...
Yeah, so I think that inherently... Even though you put a good case there, the thing just doesn't work. In fact, it may be that just large entities don't work for human beings. It might just be that the way that we're made is that we're made for small entity rule.
We're all tribal at the end of the day.
We might even be, you know, tribal is a nice way of saying big family.
Yeah.
And la familia is the thing.
Right, I agree.